Hey, what's going on, guys? I'm Sasha Gregory, and this is the Superheroes Unlimited mod review. So, this mod adds tons of, like, superhero costumes and abilities and weapons and ores, all kinds of things. And I think it's a really cool mod, and no one's really done any, like, reviews or tutorials over it for some reason, and it's just really cool. So, as you can see, I'm wearing an Iron Man costume, and with it, I can fly. But it also adds things like speed 3, strength, and resistance, so that's just a few things we'll be seeing. With the Iron Man costumes, you kind of get this, like, weird setup whenever you put the helmet on, kind of like here, and the Iron Man helmet. So, yeah, you can run really fast, and, yeah, I'm gonna take this off just so it's a little easier to see. You can still fly and stuff, but, this is my best friend and pet sheep, Murray. Say hello, Murray. Alright. And, yeah, so, they have both DC heroes and Marvel heroes, so there's tons of shit heroes you can choose from. These are just a few of them, or most of the DC heroes. So you can have Superman, Batman, Wonder Woman, Green Lantern, Flash, Martian Manhunter, Aquaman, Green Arrow, and Robin. Some of their abilities don't activate unless you have all of their outfits, so be prepared for that. And yeah, so I'm going to put on, let's say, Martian Manhunter's outfit. Actually, let's see how to craft that. So, Martian. Alright, so, these crafting recipes are pretty difficult to make, but it's understandable since they give you such great abilities. So, like, you need emerald, green cloth, and red cloth. The cloth are new recipes that you have to use string and wool to make. So if you need red cloth, you need to have red wool and string. So that's how you make wool. Cloth. So they are pretty hard to make. So like Martian Manhunter, you need emeralds for it, and that's pretty hard to get. And string can sometimes be a pain to get, but let's try looking at Deadpool. He also has a sword. So Deadpool, he just takes white cloth, so Deadpool's pretty easy. Some of them are pretty easy, but some of them are really tough. Let's look at Superman's. Superman's, you have to have the Superman logo, Ruby Gems, and Sapphire Gems. Rubies and Sapphires are a new ore that it adds, and yeah, Superman's logo, you need a Nether Star. Yeah, a Nether Star. So have fun killing that Wither Boss. And Ruby Gems. So some of these hero costumes can be very difficult to make, but if you just want to, like, I don't know, cheat or just mess around and stuff and just have a costume there. They're for the taking. This is the Iron Man. I was wearing the Iron Man's Hulkbuster costume. And there's like 3 or 4 other Iron Man costumes. And so, as you can see, I look like Martian Manhunter. I can fly. And he has speed, strength 3, and invisibility. Every superhero costume gives different abilities, so that was the DC heroes. Now we're going to go look at some of the Marvel heroes. I'm not going to go over every single costume because that would take a really long time. You already saw Iron Man Hulkbuster costume. They have the normal one, Captain America, Thor, Hulks, Ant-Man, Wasp, Deadpool's, Spider-Man's, and Wolverine's. So, I've used Deadpool before. I'm not going to wear it, but you pretty much get regenerative abilities, so it will be really hard for you to die, but if you take so much damage on your costume, the enchantments will just disappear, so you gotta be careful with that. Don't just get cocky just because you're invincible for a little while. So, I'm gonna take Thor's costume. Take off Martian Manhunter's. I'm the almighty, powerful Thor. So, you get speed, strength 3, fire resistant, and invisibility. My face is kind of invisible. I don't know why. Maybe that's a little glitch. I don't think I had that before. Or maybe it's just the skin I'm wearing because it has a mask on it. I don't know. But, so, he can't fly for some reason. But, actually, there is a reason. But, so you're like, aw, but can't Thor fly? Well, no, he can't fly. So, the way you fix this is there's a weapon in this chest, and it is Mjolnir. Mjolnir is like the ultimate weapon in this mod. It has 52 damage. You're going to one-shot anything with it. And when you're holding it, you can fly. So, that's how Thor flies anyways. Another cool feature is if you right-click, Yes! You can catch things on lightning. Or strike thing. Also, you can't see it on this, but this has 99,999 uses. So, every little lightning strike counts as a use. Every little block you break counts as a use. This thing can mine anything. It can chop down trees. It's like the ultimate tool. So, it's an ultimate sword, pickaxe, diamond pickaxe, everything. You can even enchant it. So, although you don't really need to, because it's so powerful anyways, but hey, if you want to and have a shiny one that glows, knock stuff out. So, I'll just spawn this cow here and just one-shot. You can just pretty much one-shot anything. It's really cool to have. So, we're going to get rid of that. And let's go back over here and get back in order. Alright, so with Batman, he obviously doesn't have any powers, but they have a bunch of bat gadgets. So there's the Batarang, Grappling Hook, Bat Bomb, Sonic Bat Call, Throwing Bird. There's also like Robins and Batgirls, although I don't think Batgirl is on here yet. Bat Glider, I wanted to try that. I haven't used that yet. So I haven't used all of these, but I guess spawn a bunch of cows and try it out. Bat Glider. It's not really doing anything. Let's try Smoke Pellet. Whoa! Oh, that's cool. So, obviously it's your smoke. Robin's Grappling Hook. How far can this go? Oh, you like throw something. So you pretty much just teleport. It's not even really a Grappling Hook. It's like an Ender Pearl. I don't know if you take damage. Game mode S. It appears you don't take... Actually, let me get rid of this Thor suit so we can tell or not. So you don't take damage when using it. So that's a really cool feature, too. Throwing Bird. Ah! Take this, stupid cows. Sonic Bat Call. Well, I guess that obviously calls bats. I don't know what I was expecting. next is the Bat Bomb. Whoa! Alright, that was pretty deadly. Batman's Grappling Hook probably does the same thing. Yep, Batarang. That's pretty good far reach. Yeah, I kind of stuck at aiming. They don't seem like they're that strong, though. And it took multiple hits on the cow. But, let's go back to game mode. C. Get rid of some of these things. Bam. And... Oh yeah, let's go back up here to Bat Gadgets. Here we are. Robin's Battle Staff. We already know what Grappling Hook's do. I'm not going to use the Damien Staff. It's probably the same thing. That's probably just a weapon too. Antidote. Batgirl's Grappling Hook. Alright, so we're going to turn this to day. Spawn some more cows in. Antidote Pill. I'm not sure what the Antidote Pill does, but... Wingding? Fear by Wingding! Robin's Battle Staff. Alright, I guess it's just kind of sword. Yeah, it has 7 attack damage, so it's pretty strong too. Alright, so let's destroy a few of these things. And then look at more of the weapons and such. So that's pretty much all the bat gadgets we went through. Next are all the new monsters that this mod adds in, such as the Country Prisoner, a Crook, Thug, Fishman, a Tamed Ant, a Regular Ant, and a Radioactive Spider. Alright, so let's move over here. The Radioactive Spider, prepare yourself. Holy crap! Yes, this thing is big, it is fast, it is mean, it will destroy you. It has a really weird hitbox, because whenever I'm playing on, whenever I was playing on, survival mode and everything, this thing was super fast. I don't know why it isn't very fast now. It was just... Here, let me go to survival mode real quick. I'm scared. Wait, why is that time day? Wow. As you can see, that thing is fast. And it killed me in, like, no problem. So, beware if you see one of those. So, that was a warning. As you can see, he just completely obliterated me, like, no problem. You didn't even really see it coming, 2 hits. Of course, I wasn't wearing their armor and stuff, but they're really hard to kill. And you have to kill them if you want to make Spider-Man's costume, so that can be a pain in the butt if you want Spider-Man's costume. Alright, let's get all my eggs back. Put these back up here. And... okay. So, whoops, I'm gonna put the helmet on. Alright, so we... alright, now let's try the Fishman. Oh! Okay, I guess Fishman are docile creatures. They appear to drop fish and green aqua stone. I'm gonna have to kill this guy real quick. These guys also have 50 health, so they can be a pain in the butt to kill, and they drop radioactive silk. Throw that in the hole. Alright, let's try to spawn the Fishman again. And then, game mode S. Alright, they seem friendly. And if you hit them, they appear to hit back. So beware for that. And yeah, so they're pretty passive, I guess. Except for one of them, unless you hit them. Alright, a tamed ant. Alright, with these ants, I noticed with Ant-Man, he has this device that spawns a bunch of ants in. And if he gets hit, they like jump on him and they heal his health, so I don't know. Ew, do you hear that nasty sound they make? It's nasty. Country prisoner. Alright, this is the bad guy. Oh, the ants do not like him. So I guess the ants will help you fight enemies. Oh, that's really cool. Leave my ants alone! Go, ant army! Kill him! So these ants and mobs, they can be found usually outside at night or, actually I've seen some at daytime and inside caves. They drop, limonite ore? Or ingots? I don't know how to pronounce that. Alright, we already did the spider. This is just a regular ant. I guess you can tame them somehow to get tamed ants. And then a thug. Alright, these are the guys I see out at daytime. Oh. Okay, I guess dead ants drop ant legs. Ew. That's nasty. Alright, so there's all the eggs, or all the, new mobs adds into the game. And let's go to our next chest. So our next chest is willpower items. So these are like Green Lantern items. And, you have to find... let's see here, what is it? Willpower ore to make them. So Green Lantern's ring, if you right-click, it shoots like these little weird orbs out. These little green balls out. I don't know how strong they are, but... yeah, it has a 14 attack damage, so it's pretty strong. Next we got the willpower sword. That's 12 attack. Really good items overall, and then we have the willpower paxel, and that is, here, let's try to see how to craft that. Willpower paxel, so click here, you need the pickaxe, the sword, the axe, the shovel, and a hoe. So it's like the ultimate multitask tool. If you right click on grass, it does that. You can dig, look at shovel, you can kill things, you can mine, you can do anything with this pickaxe, and it's amazing. So, there's the new tools, or willpower tools. There's also another tool that I've had in my inventory. If you couldn't see it before, here it is. It's called the Kryptonite Pickaxe. And it's just pretty much a little bit stronger than a diamond pickaxe, and yeah, it's pretty good. That's pretty much basically all that does. So blocks, adds all the cloths, so radioactive black, all kinds of cloths, and then it adds lightning stone. Blocks, black iron blocks, kryptonite, aqua stones, all kinds of aqua stone. Uru block, gamma radiation block, titanium, vibranium, adamantium, ruby, limonite, purple crystal block, amazonian stone fragment, sapphire ore, radioactive web, black radioactive web, willpower ore, willpower dust ore, and Wakanda stone fragment. So there's tons of new ores and adds and that you're going to really need, and some can be very tricky to find, such as Mjolnir is a really hard weapon to make, and I forgot what you used to make him, but check it out, Mjolnir. So for Mjolnir, you need to make his hammer top and the hammer hilt. So for the top, you're going to need Uru blocks, and Uru I found quite difficult to find, and you're going to need 9 of the ingots to make a block, just to make that. To make the hilt, you just need 3 pieces of wood, and so that, yeah, that's pretty easy to make. Alright, last but not least, we have weapons. So, these are all the weapons that it adds into the game. Some of them, I don't know if they work, I haven't really used many of them. This is Iron Man's, I think, repulsive. Pretty much like a really long grenade. Green arrows. I'm not seeing anything come out of it, though. But I guess it is shooting things out of it. Whoa, what is up with that? The arrows, like, shoot really weird. Do the arrows... I think the arrows try to home in on things, or maybe not. I don't know. That's kind of weird. Oh, Aquaman's trident summons these things to help fight for you. Alright, so... Okay, they're fighting the ants. I didn't know ants were mean. And it also has a lot of attack damage. And... Alright, Lasso of Truth. I'm thinking this is Wonder Woman's weapon. And it just looks pretty strong. One hit a cow. Pistol. Alright, that's a weird animation, but I guess it'll do. Bring on Fisherman. Next we got Deadpool's sword. Just a basic sword. Kryptonite sword, another basic sword. Wolverine's claws. They're pretty strong. And the Joker's card, I don't know what that does. I guess you just throw them. It's kind of like all the other throwing weapons. Alright, now that we're done with that, we just got the last few to go over. Alright, weapons. Captain America's shield, Spider-Man's web shooter, Sonic Ant Call, Wasp Thing, Pink... Black Panthers, Claws, Red Hood, and all kinds of stuff. Alright, so, oh, that's pretty cool looking. So, you can throw Captain America's shield. Shoot. Oh, so this is kind of like a grappling hook, too. Sonic Ant's Call just spawns a bunch of ants, and then if something hits you... Oh, no, get away! Wasp Stinger just shoots things. Another claw, kind of like Wolverine's. Just a simple dagger. Red hoods and grenades. Damn. 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 So yeah, that's basically all there pretty much is in this mod, except for these materials, which I'm not gonna go over because there's so many. And so I think Murray really enjoys this. Murray, what happened to your name? Murray. Someone stole Murray's identity. So, but I believe this is still Murray, though. Yes. Yes. I'm sorry. I don't know who stole your name, but we will find him. And we will destroy him. For I am Iron Man! Alright, so I hope you guys really enjoyed this mod. It's a really cool mod. It is multiplayer compatible, so you can play with your friends on the server. And, yeah, so right after this video, there's going to be a tutorial on how to install this mod, and... see you then. Alright, so to install this mod, all you're going to need is just two things. Minecraft Forge and the Superheroes Unlimited mod. I'm going to have the links to both of those in the description, but whenever you go to Minecraft Forge and click on that link, it should say for legacy builds, please click here. So just click that. Scroll down until over here, you'll see 1.6.2. Go over here to Installer and click that. It should bring you to AdFly. Just wait till this counts down to 0. And you'll click Skip Ad. Keep the file. There's no virus, I promise you. And it should download. After that, the next link for the Superheroes mod, you're going to scroll down and click Previous Versions. Then, Minecraft version 1.6.2. Just click here, open it. Should bring you to AdFly. Once it's done skipping through and everything, press Skip Ad. It should bring you to a MediaFire website. Or it's redirecting me, yep. Then you just click Download right here, and it should start downloading. Alright, so now that we're done with that, time to install it. First, you're going to have to open Minecraft. Might take me a second. This is the new launcher, by the way, so what you're going to do is, down here, you're going to click New Profile, name it 1.6.2, go down here to Use Latest Version, click the drop-down list, and click on 1.6.2. I already did it, but click Save Profile, and then click Play. Once it's fully loaded, so click Play, and then once this is fully loaded and it pops up and everything, just close it out. Alright, so next you're going to double-click the Minecraft Forge Installer. You should make sure it's checklisted on Install Client. Now that it is, just press OK, and it should download it for you. It may take a few minutes, but not that long. Alright, so successfully installed. Press OK, and you're gonna start Minecraft up again. Alright, so now that Minecraft is open, you're gonna click this drop down list again, and then go to Forge. So once you click Forge, just right here, just click Play, and then just press Play again. Make sure you press Play and load Minecraft. Because what this does is activates Forge, so it adds like all the folders and everything in your .minecraft folder. Alright, so now that's here, you can tell that's working because it says Mods, it says Minecraft Forge. So now you're just going to quit the game, go down to the Start button, type percent, app data, percent, enter, and it should bring up this folder, or this, yeah. You should see .minecraft, double-click that, double-click Mods, and all you're going to do is take the superhero mod, just take it, and then drag it into there. And that's it, you've installed the mod. It's really that simple, it's incredibly easy, and that's how you install most Forge mods, if you guys didn't know. The hardest part is just installing Forge, so you gotta make sure it's on Forge every time. Click Play. Wait for it to load. And alright, so now I sit here, it says 4 mods loaded, click here. It says Mod Unlimited, Superheroes Unlimited Mod. That means it's successfully installed and yeah, it should be working. It's really that simple and yeah. So thank you so much for watching. Please leave a like, subscribe, and I guess I'll talk to you guys later. Bye.